Cumberland Presbyterian Church. It's always good to be gathered in God's house on his Sabbath day to worship, and we're going to worship him in a way today that I think will make us all just smile. Let me call your attention to the announcements that are in the bulletin. Of course, there will be a potluck right after church today. Next Sunday, there will be a congregational meeting for the purpose of electing three elders to the class of 2025. And at that time, the nominating committee will be placing the name of Gordon Hanna, Ashley Lindsay, and Jim Smith in nomination. Let me remind you of our Christmas Eve service on the 24th. If you're not able to come to the Christmas Eve candlelight service, we will have a come and go from 2 until 3. On December the 25th, we will have Sunday school. I will tell you that I am sorely distressed at some of the churches who have canceled their services on Christmas Day. I think, can you imagine? The birthday of the Lord, and we stay home. We're going to be here. No Sunday school. No Sunday school.
Okay, no Sunday school.
Yeah, no Sunday school. Worship at 10:30. Jordan, you have an announcement?
I have two things. One, the registration for our youth retreat to Gatlinburg is due Tuesday. So if that interests you, please get that to me. If you need a new one, I'll send it to you. Whatever needs to be done, we can get it done. And then this Wednesday, we have our youth Christmas party from 5 to 7. There will be food. You don't need to bring anything except your kid, please, or else I won't be able to have a party. It's going to be a great time. We always have fun. You won't want to miss it. Thank you.
Prayer concerns. I have a couple. I talked with Brother Steve this morning, and he's had a couple of hard days. And in fact, he's not preaching this morning. He doesn't feel like he can stand on his legs to do that. So we need to remember Brother Steve. My grandson, his wife, was tragically killed this week. And I'd like for you to remember Jasmine Osterhaus and, of course, my grandson John and that family as they go through the grieving process. Are there others we need to remember? Joanne Hall. And the other? Soon we shall celebrate the birth of Jesus. We worship God with joy in our hearts as we are reminded of the words the angel said on that first Christmas day. Behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will come to all people. Thank you. pray. Father, we are here in this place at this time to acknowledge you as our God and our Creator. We come praising you, Lord, for your Son, Jesus Christ, whose birth we are celebrating. Praising you, Lord, for the love that you freely bestow upon us. We praise you, Lord, for the opportunities that you have given us to experience your joy and your peace and your calm. Precious God, help us to enter into a time of worship. May we bow our hearts. May we listen to the message that is going to be presented to us today. Help us, Lord, to experience your joy and to give you that praise. In Jesus' holy name, amen. This time we'll have the lighting of our candle.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem, Magi from the east came seeking him and asked, "Where is the one who has been born king of the Jews? We saw his star in the east, and we have come to worship him." And the star they had seen went ahead of them, and they stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, the Magi were filled with joy.
In gratitude for wise men and seekers everywhere in search of Christ, we light this candle of joy. Hear the word of the Lord. I will turn your mourning into gladness. I will give you comfort and joy instead of sorrow. I tell you the truth, you may weep and mourn while the world rejoices. You may grieve, but your grief will turn to joy.
For the Magi of yesterday who crossed the expanse of nations, and for those who bridge chasms of the heart, earnestly seeking the source of everlasting joy, we give thanks.
Stand and sing together, as with gladness, men of old.
Thank you.
What can I give him, poor as I am? If I were a shepherd, I would bring him a lamb. If I were a wise man, I would do my part. Yet what can I give him? I'll give him my heart. Let us worship God for giving of his tithes and offerings. We come to praise you and glorify you with the giving of these tithes and offerings. We pray, Lord, that we have given with a joyful heart, that we have given with the understanding, Lord, that we are your body. And Lord, we ask that you would receive and consecrate these offerings. And we pray, Lord, your blessing to be upon them. We pray for your guiding hand as we seek to be your body in our community. And I pray and I ask all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Be seated. Pastor. You have a prayer list in your bulletin, and you've heard those lifted. So at this time, let us pray. Father, we know that so often we hurry through our day without giving you proper thanks. We pray, Lord, that we would understand and realize that as a blessed child of yours, that we aren't free from trouble, but we are strengthened by your presence. We lift these, Lord, that are on our prayer list. We lift them to you, Lord, asking that you would meet them at their points of need. And Lord, if it's a gift of healing, we pray for your healing touch. We know sometimes, Lord, you heal by giving warmth, or you heal by giving joy, or you heal by giving comfort. So, Lord, we do ask that healing. Lord, we especially lift this morning our brother Steve. The family of Jasmine Osterhaus. Joanne Hale, Jan Hives, Jim Worthington. We just pray, Lord, that there are so many more that are on our heart. So we pause, Lord, lifting them to you, asking, Lord, your presence in their life. Thank you, Lord, for hearing us. Lord, I ask that not only do you hear, but you would give us the strength to see you move in our lives. And Lord, that we understand that our prayers are answered. So help us, Lord, to be strong and to look. Help us to be attentive. Give us, Lord, that direction as we pray the prayer your Son Jesus taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning. I want to start just for just a second and thank a couple people. When we get ready to come up with a Christmas program, we're like, okay, where are we going to come up with one? So Paula brought me a little bag of goodies back from her church, and so we went through it and came up with our play. The only problem was it had no music with it, and we knew we had to have music, so we worked with the kids, and we all came up with the music that we were going to sing. Tamara then took our stuff and put it all together for us. We then handed it over to Jeff. He made us our CDs for our kids and also put all of our words on the screen for us. So I want to thank Paula, Tamara, and Jeff. And also, this is our future. These guys are absolutely amazing. So at this point, at this time, it's amazing to present them to you for the 12 Symbols of Christmas.
Okay, kids, are you ready to get the house ready for Christmas?
I love getting ready for Christmas.
It's my favorite time of the year.
It makes me get in the mood for Christmas.
Yeah, I guess.
Put stuff in as full as the house you get in my way.
Girls, I'm so glad you're excited about it, but you must remember that the stuff, as Stanley puts it, means something as well.
What do you mean, Mom?
Well, why do we celebrate Christmas?
It's Jesus' birthday.
It's when we remember that Jesus came into this world as a baby.
That's right.
Why do we have to decorate them?
Yeah, why do we have to fill up our house with all this stuff?
Well, let's talk about some of this stuff and what it all means. Let's start with the evergreen tree that we are decorating.
An evergreen tree has a very appropriate name. It is evergreen, always green. It does not become dormant in the winter as other trees do. The color green represents new life, and the needles of the evergreen always point up, heavenward. It symbolizes our everlasting life with Jesus Christ. We should be as the evergreen tree, always full of life, never becoming dormant in our life with Christ as our arms are lifted heavenward. The bread of God is the one who comes down from heaven. He gives life to the world. John 6:33.
I didn't realize. Wow, I didn't either.
ornaments are used to decorate Christmas trees each year. People look for the perfect ones to fit on their tree. Our Christmas tree just wouldn't seem complete without our ornaments. Ornaments can symbolize the blessings in our lives. Our lives just wouldn't be complete without God's blessings. Everything we have is due to God loving us so much that he wants to shower us with his blessings. Just as ornaments are all different shapes and sizes, blessings are all different as well. God picks and chooses each blessing for us so that it will be just right. The next time you decorate a tree, as you put up each ornament, think of a blessing that God has given you. I think you'll find that you can run out of ornaments before you can run out of blessings. Every man shall give as he is able, according to the blessings of the Lord your God that he has given you. Deuteronomy 16:17.
Blessings.
We have so many blessings.
We have our home and our family.
It's hard to think of all the blessings that God has given us.
Okay, so I guess it's not so bad. And it does look nice.
Oh, there's so much more. How about we talk about the lights and candles?
Lights and candles are used to give light. When a room is full of darkness, it is dark. But if you light a single match in a dark room, the room is light. There may be more darkness, but the light overpowers it. We are that light. We can be the single light in a world of darkness. We must share our light with the world so that the light increases. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand. And it gives light to all in the house. Matthew 5:14 through 15.
The bell rings out to guide the lost sheep back to the fold, signifying that all are precious in the eyes of the Lord. Jesus is our shepherd, and he laid down his life for us so that we may spend eternity with him in heaven. He is calling us to follow him through his word. Are you going to listen? If a man has 100 sheep and one of them has gone astray, does he not leave in the 99 on the mountain and go in search of the one that went astray? Matthew 18:12. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. John 10:11.
Thank you.
sound so beautiful. I just love to listen to them.
Jesus is our shepherd.
We are his sheep.
Can we go looking for me?
Who likes candy canes?
Me!
Symbolizes multiple things. If you hold it upright, it looks like a shepherd's crook. The shepherds were some of the few people who were able to see the baby Jesus in Bethlehem. If you turn the candy cane upside down, it looks like a J. Jesus starts with the letter J. The colors of the candy cane are also symbolic. The red represents the blood that Jesus shed for us on the cross, and the white represents the purity of Jesus. There are candy canes with three smaller red stripes running around it. These stripes symbolize the Trinity, God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Who knew that this delicious, simple candy was so profoundly symbolic of our Lord Jesus Christ and his simple birth? And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Matthew 1:21.
Seems to be a reason why we do everything that we do.
I can see how this stuff has meaning.
I'm so glad that you're changing your mind about some of these things. I have some stars to put on the tree next.
The star is a heavenly sign of prophecy fulfilled ages ago, the shining hope for all mankind. The star led the wise men to find the baby Jesus. These wise men traveled many miles following a star in the sky. The star was their guiding light to the Savior. God was the wise men's travel agent, in sorts, leading them to the greatest destination known to man, the Savior. We now have his word as our guiding light to lead us to be with him in heaven. Are you going to follow him? And behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. Matthew 2:9-10.
That must have been an amazing journey.
I'm glad that we have the Bible now to help lead us.
Yes, God's words lead us to Jesus.
Well, I think our tree is almost finished. We just need to put the angel on top.
Imagine, you are a lowly shepherd watching over your sheep. This night seems no different than any other. Then suddenly, an angel of the Lord is in the sky above you, telling you of the Savior's birth. You a shepherd? Why did God send an angel to tell shepherds? Because the message that God had about the birth of Jesus was for all people. Not just for the right, not just for the Jew, everyone. God chose his number one messenger to tell the lowest of people in the world's eyes of his son's birth. God looks at the heart, not what the world looks at. Thank goodness. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. Luke 10:9-11.
We have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
We see holly as decorations during the Christmas season, but do we really understand what holly stands for? The leaves represent the crown of thorns that were placed upon Jesus' head as he was being crucified. The berries symbolize the blood that he shed for us. He endured criticism, excruciating pain, and embarrassment, all for you and I. The next time you see a decoration with holly on it, remember what was done for you so that he could spend eternity with you. I know that I will. And twisting together a crown of thorns, they put it on his head and put a reed in his right hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying, Hail, King of the Jews. Matthew 27:29.
strength to die for me and you.
That's why I made you think about during this Christmas season.
That leads us to this wreath that will hang on the wall.
The wreath has its evergreen branches bent in a circle so that the ends touch, having no beginning or end, just as there is no beginning or end of Jesus' internal love for us. Just as the wreath looks the same throughout and seems not to change, so he will always be the same. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Hebrews 13:8.
I just love how it looks on our wall. Yes, it really finishes off the look of the room. It's nice to know that he will never change.
I didn't realize that it had a meaning.
That's a great reminder that even though we change and go, he'll always be right there. Now what about the presents? Those can't happen to me.
Well, you'd be surprised then.
These days, the world has forgotten the reason for Christmas. Most people seem to think that getting presents is the greatest thing about Christmas. Other people seem to think that presents have nothing to do with Christmas. Well, they are both wrong. The wise men came to visit Jesus as a young child and gave him presents. They gave him gold, frankincense, and myrrh. They offered him gold as a king, paying him tribute. Frankincense as God, for they honored God with the smoke of frankincense, and myrrh, as a man that should die, for myrrh was used in embalming dead bodies. These wise men, saw this child and knew that he is a king, is God, and that he would die for the sins of the world. How can anyone, with the knowledge that we have now, not believe? The wise men went to the house. There they saw the child with his mother Mary. They bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures. They gave him gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Matthew 2:11.
Many people spend hours wrapping all of their presents during Christmas time. They use ribbons, garlands, and bows to make sure that their presents are as beautiful as possible. What they don't realize is that the items that they use to complete the outside of the gift have more meaning than the actual gift inside. The bow ties our present with a beautiful ribbon, just as Jesus ties us as Christians together in his love. We may not be in the same family, but we are all in the family of God. Jesus is the ribbon that binds us together. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Colossians 3:14.
I just thought the wrappings were to hide the person inside.
Yeah, I never thought about them having their meaning.
There is really a lot to think about.
I guess I'll have to look at things differently.
Well, that's for sure. Never knew that all this stuff had meaning.
People do get a little crazy with the stuff of Christmas. The parties, the gift giving, the busyness of the Christmas season. What we need to do is slow down and enjoy every moment by remembering the true meaning of Christmas. Who wants a cookie?
I know there's not me in a cookie.
Oh, you'd be surprised.
Making cookies is a favorite pastime for most families during the Christmas season. Cookie cutters are used to turn ordinary dough into edible masterpieces. God doesn't use cookie cutters when he creates each one of us. He makes every one of us so special and unique that he would have to break the mold after just one use. He is the potter and we are his clay. He wants to mold us into his masterpieces. We only need to be moldable and willing to follow his lead. Behold, like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. Jeremiah 18:6.
Certainly heard the Christmas message this morning, a blessing. And as Dana was going through all the ones that she wanted to thank for helping, I think she left out Dana and Jake. As the acolyte comes forward, I'm going to ask you to allow the children to go first with their parents and pastor. Worth a shot, so that they can go ahead and eat and enjoy their time of fellowship and being together. I am going to bless the food before we go back there, so that when you get back there, you can go ahead and eat. I know sometimes it's hard to get everybody to be in one spot and quiet all together, so we'll do that. So I will have the blessing, and then I will pronounce the benediction. If you would please stand. Father God, we just praise and thank you for the witness of these children. We just praise you, Lord, for the love that they have shared with us. We just praise you, Lord, for the guiding hand that you have placed upon them. We ask now, Lord, that as we go into a time of fellowship, that we would be grateful for the food that you have prepared for us. And ask, Lord, that you would bless it. as we fellowship one with another. And now, may the grace of God be upon each one of you. May you be filled with His love, His joy, and His peace. Go forth and share His love in Jesus' holy name. Amen.